The UK honours system should be scrapped. It's not the right way to recognise those who make a contribution to society. The system is an anachronistic relic of a bygone age, harking back to the days of the British Empire, and is based on patronage and deference. There are tens of thousands of citizens who day in, day out, act heroically, but they don't strive for letters before or after their name. They do it because they care. These are the people whose contributions should be recognised.
And Neil joins us to debate his arguments with the political editor of Talk Radio, Peter Cardwell, who's a former special advisor to Conservative cabinet ministers. Thank you both for joining us. Neil, a lot of the knighthoods and damehoods grab a lot of publicity, but isn't it the case that a lot of non-famous people get these awards for really viable work they do, you know, within society? So isn't it a bit of an overreaction to say get rid of it altogether?
Yeah, of course, normal people, you know, get put forward for honours, but it's dominated by, 50% of people who get honours are privately educated. That's nowhere near the percentage of people within the community. There's an over-concentration of people who live and work in a small area of London who get honours. We know that it's the diplomats, it's the civil servants, it's the former politicians, it's the party donors who dominate the honours system. And where is the recognition for the hundreds of thousands, if not millions, of key workers who have kept us going through the COVID pandemic? They're the real heroes, they're the real glue that holds society together, not the the party donors and the political connections of whichever government is in of the day.
Let's get Peter's reaction to that. Is it for the elite? What about these, you know, thousands of people that have been doing this amazing work during the pandemic, for instance? They're not getting recognised.
I think they are being recognised. I remember clapping for carers. I remember so many people saying what a brilliant job the NHS has done right across the United Kingdom, and well done to them. I think the honour system is something a bit separate. I think there are many people who are recognised for a lifetime of service. The problem I have with the honour system is those who are given awards for simply making a lot of money. Sir Mick Jagger, for example, has made an awful lot of money being a Rolling Stone. Should he get a knighthood? Probably not. But I think there are lots of people who've used their gongs for good, like Joanna Lumley, for example. She's very well known as an actress. She's been made a dame, but she's been made the dame for her charity work and the fact that she has used her public position to stand up for people who had no voice, the Gurkhas, for example, and many other groups. So I think there is a lot to recognise here.
Peter, what did you think about what Neil was saying, that it's a relic of the bygone age, you know, it harks back to the British Empire?
I don't think there's anything wrong with that necessarily. I think a lot of people think the British Empire was all bad. It wasn't all bad and it wasn't all good. Of course it wasn't, but it's our history. And I think that these things that exist are not so terrible. There are many awards that have existed for a much shorter time and even since the end of the empire as well. Look, they're a bit anachronistic, they're maybe a little bit silly, but I think it's a lovely thing to do. It's a lovely thing to receive and many people are very, very proud to receive them.
Neil, what's your response to that? What's wrong with harking back to tradition? And also Peter saying that gongs can be for good. Look at what Joanna Lumley has done.
Well, first of all, Peter said that key workers are being recognised. Clapping for carers isn't quite the same as a seat in the House of Lords and £300 a shift when you turn up, if you turn up, or all the doors that a knighthood can open for you. So I think, you know, to equate a clap for carers and pay cuts for many public sector workers to the award of a gong from the government of the day is just frankly absurd. But what Peter doesn't also mention, I think he's right in mentioning people who get awards for just them earning lots of cash. But many of these are the captains of industry that the government of the day schmooze up to. These are often tax-dodging businessmen, political donors who are in it to get contracts or some sort of benefit from the government. And the whole system just becomes utterly corrupt. And no matter how many smatterings of lollipop men or women or school janitors you put into the honours list, it doesn't equate to the numbers of people from the establishment and the political elite who get these honours.
Peter, I interrupted you. On you go.
No, I just wondered if Neil would give a knight hood or a dame hood to every single person who works in the NHS, for example. I mean, you're talking about over a million people. I think there are certainly people who should be really well recognised for the amazing work they do. The thing as well with honours is that with the, he talks about members of the House of Lords, which is slightly different to the honour system itself, although obviously being a lord would be, or a baroness would be an honour for many people. But if we're talking specifically about MBEs, CBEs and knighthoods and things like that, there is no monetary value to those. They are simply an award. They are a title, of course, or letters after your name. And many people are very, very glad to receive them. They love the day out when they're awarded them. They're popular in their community for doing so. And it is a wonderful recognition for many people. The very first editor who ever published a piece of mine, the local newspaper editor who was the editor for 30 years, worked incredibly hard, could have gone a lot further into much bigger newspapers, stayed in his local community. He got an MBE. That was a wonderful thing. And everybody was really happy for him.
And Neil, what would you replace it with?
Well, I think there has to be a different system that does recognise people within the community who make significant contributions. And it has to be a more democratic and open system. I don't have a magic wand to say what it would be replaced with, because I think that needs a bit of thought. But I think it could be done through local government, where people know the people in the community who are making the big contributions. You know, I know the people in my community who have gone way beyond the call of duty to serve the community during the COVID crisis. They are absolute heroes. None of them are likely to be recognised in the honours system. Instead, you'll get people like Michelle Moan, who's been recognised for what? I have no idea. Ian Duncan Smith, Danny Alexander. These are the people who are being given awards. For God's sake, what are these people being rewarded for? I have no idea.
I mean, Peter, what do you think of that as an idea?
Well, it's interesting that Neil doesn't appear to trust the London establishment to give people awards, but he does appear to trust local government. I wonder why local politicians and councillors, for example, wouldn't feel even more pressure to give awards to the local luminaries and those who have perhaps donated or helped them in their quest to get into local council. So I don't think his argument quite stacks up.
No, okay,
I'm
we're really running out of time.
Politicians who would award that at all.
Okay, but Peter, tell me, if you were awarded an award, would you accept it?
I think it's highly unlikely I'll ever be given anything. Maybe a Mars bar or a can of Coke or something for my efforts, but I'd love to. Yes, I would happily accept it. And it's interesting, even people who are anti-royalist often accept it. They remember their day out to the palace. I think it's a very special thing, part of the fabric of our society.
Okay.
And it's a wonderful thing for people who receive them.
Neil, I don't know, should I even bother asking you? I take it the answer would be no.
Well, the answer is no. And I wouldn't say Peter should give up hope. I mean, David Cameron's hairdresser was given an honour. I don't think Boris Johnson's hairdresser would quite make the cut
Maybe
the guy who's selling carry-outs for Downing Street might.
Okay, we'll leave it there. But Neil and Peter, thanks very much indeed for joining us.